It's a phenomenon that can dump feet of snow in one area, and a few miles away, it could be bright and sunny. Lake effect snow. And for those of us here in Northeast Ohio, it's a way of life in wintertime. But what is it exactly? I'm Tony, naturalist with Lake Metro Parks, and today I'm going to give you guys the basics of lake effect snow. For lake effect snow to work, we need a few specific conditions in place. We need a cold air mass, a relatively warm body of water, and wind. At the time of this recording, the lake temperature at Lake Erie is 44 degrees. A little cold to go swimming, but compared to the air temperature, it's relatively warm, which means the air above it is fairly warm as well. And in addition to that warmth, it's also moist. When a cold air mass from, say, Canada moves into the area, that much colder and also much drier air mixes with the warm, moist lake air. This draws warm air up where it condenses and forms clouds. Now here's where the wind comes in. The wind that moves that cold air mass in the first place continues blowing, pushing those clouds over land, releasing the water vapor built up as snow. Sounds pretty simple, right? But if these conditions aren't just right, you're not going to get any snow. For example, if the wind's moving in too fast, well, that air doesn't have enough time to condense and form water vapor, and you might get some clouds, but you're really not going to get any precipitation. On the other hand, if the temperature isn't just right, you won't get that condensation either. The air temperature at 5,000 feet needs to be at least 23 degrees colder than the lake temperature. If the incoming air is too warm, we may get some rain, but there'll be no snow. And when the lake is frozen over, the air above it isn't warm enough or moist enough to create lake effect snow. Which is why in January and February, when the lake's usually frozen over, we see a drop-off in lake effect snow. When all these ingredients mix just right, bands of snow begin to fall downwind. These bands form parallel to the wind direction, causing heavy and localized snowfall. The snow essentially appears out of nowhere. That's why looking at a radar doesn't really help. You can't look at the radar and see snow out over the lake moving in. It kind of just forms as it hits land. This is the so-called lake effect snow machine that you hear so many local meteorologists talk about. And the only way to turn that machine off is to wait for those conditions to change. Lake effect snow can happen anywhere, as long as the conditions are right. In fact, every one of the Great Lakes produces lake effect snow. But since Lake Erie's the shallowest, with an average depth of about 210 feet, it's warmer, and therefore produces heavier snow. In fact, Lake Erie produces some of the most significant amounts of lake effect snow in the world. Well, thanks for joining me for this brief look at lake effect snow. Don't forget to follow lakemetroparks.com and follow us on social media for more videos like this and other news and info as well. I'm Tony, and I'll see you guys next time.